Welcome back. We've been discussing 12 major reasons we must not allow the new Korean Free Trade Agreement to achieve congressional approval. We've already talked about the limits it will put on our laws, as well as the jobs it will certainly send overseas. So let's continue on our list detailing this disastrous proposed agreement. Number 3. The U.S. government will lose the ability to regulate the American banking industry. This trade deal was negotiated before the financial collapse of 2008. It contains several Wall Street financial services provisions, including bans on regulations limiting the size of banks and insurance companies, prohibitions against barring the sale of risky derivatives, and limits on capital controls. The greed that caused a failed derivatives market and allowed banks to create the housing bubble will not be able to be stopped or limited in any way because of this pact. Provisions in it will supersede any regulations we put in place to protect ourselves. Number 4. Foreign monopolies will be allowed to take over U.S. industries. This agreement will make any laws or regulations that would stop companies from becoming monopolies illegal. This will make preventing foreign takeovers impossible. With our open stock markets, not only will South Korean companies have access to buy us out with the money from our balance of trade deficit, but they will be able to buy whole industries, and we will be financially helpless to stop them. Number 5. Korea will be able to insource low-wage jobs to the U.S., but American companies will not get the same access to South Korea. The Korean Free Trade Agreement has terms that grant extreme rights for foreign investors within the U.S. that would allow them to play by different rules. The scope of what can be challenged in the U.S. is extremely broad, which means that while South Korean companies will be allowed to come here and do business as they please, American companies will not receive the same privileges in Korea's state-run system. To even consider this makes absolutely no sense. Let's leave off there. Be sure to join us again next time as we proceed with our list of damaging effects the Korean Free Trade Agreement will have on America.